saying you grab him, don't run away.
Verse 11, and after him was Shammah. Shammah's name means amazement. Eliezer's name means help of the Lord. Back again to Adino in verses 8, his name means turn to the Lord or turn over to the Lord. Somebody shout, when you turn to the Lord, you'll find the help of the Lord. And Shammah's name means amazement. Somebody shout, you'll be amazed by the Lord. Glory to God. Listen, little brother Shammah. Amen. Son of Agi. Or Agi. The Hararite. And the Philistines were getting together in a troop. Big army. Where was a piece of ground full of lentils. Somebody say red beans. And the people fled from the Philistines. But. Somebody shout, there's another butt right here. But he stood. Somebody say, he stood on his butt. But he stood in the midst of the ground and defended it. Slew the Philistines, and the Lord brought a great victory. Somebody say, he stood. Praise God. In verses 8, as the Eliezer lifted up his spear. In verse 10 of 2 Chronicles 23, or 2 Samuel 23, amen, we find, amen, Eliezer, amen, glory to God, rising up or getting up. And we find right here, amen, Shammah standing up. He stood in the midst of his ground, and he wrought a great victory, or the Lord did rather, through him as he slew the enemies. Can't you see him, Shammah, standing out there? Amen, this is his red bean patch. Come on, somebody, every year the Philistines come in to take and forage and take all, amen, that he's drew all year long. And just like last year, the year before, everybody runs off when the enemy comes. But Shammah, I see him standing there by night out there. He's a farmer. He ain't no fighter. He ain't nothing but a farmer. He takes old pitchfork, sticks it down in the ground, and thought, my God, y'all can run this year if you want to, but I ain't running nowhere. I may die right here, and you may not think there's much to this red bean patch, but it's mine. Glory to God, I planted it, I tilled it, I worked it, I fertilized it, I watered it, I kept it, and I ain't about to run from what God's gave me no more. Y'all believe me if you want to. I'm standing right here, and I'm going to fight. I know I'm a farmer, I don't know much about fighting, but I'm going to stand my ground. And when he did, the Lord somehow, he don't share details, but Holy Ghost, come on this one man, and he destroyed a whole army, a whole fruit. Simply because he trusted God and wouldn't run. One man. One God. Somebody said it's enough for victory. And just like with Eliezer, all the people, you know, that fled, they come back. Verse 13, it says these are the three of the 30 chiefs that went down and came with David in the harvest time. Somebody say in the harvest time. Friend, you'll be tempted to run away, quit, and others have left you. Anybody hear the Holy Ghost? When it's harvest time. The enemies that attacked, they attacked during harvest time. Somebody shout, the battle will really rage when it's harvest time. The devil won't come around when it's just time for planting. He comes around when it's time for the reaping. That's what the Philistines did every year. But Shammah said, not this year. Somebody ought to shout 2016, devil, not this year. I ain't running nowhere. If anybody's leaving, it's going to be you. I'm going to stand with my God, put my faith in him, and watch him defeat you. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Let's skip on down. I want our, I'm going to get into that next thing. It's in 18. I want to go to verses 20 and 21 before we close with 2 Samuel 23. Man, this is awesome here. There was another mighty man of King David. His name was Benaiah. He was the son of Jehudiah, the son of a valiant man of Kabizel, who had done many acts. He slew two lion-like men of Moab. Listen to this. He went down also and slew a lion in the midst of a pit in the time of snow. His name means Yahweh will build. Look at your neighbor and say, you can do it your way or Yahweh's. Listen, what happened? Somebody say it was wintertime. Snow was everywhere. And there was a lion caught in the pit. Now, somebody must have dug the pit, catch the lion, or catch something. And you thought, man, that's enough. The lion's in the pit. Praise God. Not for the night. This boy takes off running, jumps down in the pit in the time of snow with the lion and kills the lion. That's one thing to fight the lion, and you got a lot of room to run around him, but he's just in a little confined pit. Not big as a whale's been dug or something. Somebody shouted, he got cold feet. But he's got faith in God. Praise God. Somebody shout, even when you got cold feet, keep your faith in God. Come on and defeat lions. Somebody say, just one man, one God was enough for victory. Come on, somebody. He killed a lion. Man, I was walking around in Kenya, in East Africa, back in 2011, and we would walk right down town Nairobi at night, witnessing to people. And we had a certain men, there was just like two or three of them that accompanied us. They wore colors from their tribe. The arrangements of the pattern and the colors told what tribe they was from, and it kind of leaves my mind right now. I said, I got so much room there. Praise the Lord God. And I can't remember the name of that tribe, but to be a part of that tribe as a man, you had to kill a lion during your manhood. And these guys weren't big at all. They were real small, but they didn't nobody mess with us. Because everybody knew when they saw their colors and their arrangement, they had to kill a lion before they could wear that. You didn't have nobody to bother with us. You know, my God, you can wrestle and kill a lion? How much room you need? Go on by, son. Go on by. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. But friend, I want you to know there's a lion. Come on, somebody shout, that old devil. Praise the Lord God. Hallelujah. God wants you to know tonight, he'll try to get you to have cold feet when God tells you to do something. But hear the words of the Lord. Hear the words of faith tonight. Whatever you do, don't you allow the enemy to cause you to revert, turn back, run away, and go the other direction. Come on. Hallelujah. A slothful person, amen, according to Proverbs 26, will say there's a lion in the way. There's a lion. The lazy don't want to fight. But hear the words of the Lord tonight. God said, take your faith in me. And even if you have to do it by yourself, even if you have to stand alone, no, you're not alone. Let the Lord be for me. Who can be against me? Don't let the devil, don't let that lion intimidate you. Even when you got cold feet tonight, jump in the ditch with that lion. If you'll step into that lion's den by faith, even though you're reluctant, even though you're trembling when you go, because one time I'm afraid, I put my trust in you. Psalms 56:3, I've heard preachers preach on TV that faith and fear cannot cohabitate. Somebody shout, that's a lie. Or David would have never said, one time I'm afraid, I put my trust in you. David didn't say, faith in God's the absence of fear. He was just teaching, this is how I deal with it. I've had preachers say, well, Marvin, when does these butterflies leave when you go to the pulpit? I said, they never do, because when they do, you don't need God no more. I said, these butterflies is what the dove of heaven flights in on. Come on, somebody. As long as that butterflies is in your stomach, you'll have an odor. You'll see God. You'll realize you have no confidence in your flesh. You need him to do what you do. Come on. Anybody hear the Holy Ghost? Amen. Don't you think for one moment because you're scared that God still ain't in it and God ain't with you. Praise the Lord God. You may have cold feet. It may look, my God, as you walk toward it, I'm trembling. Even Paul said in 1 Corinthians 2, I've come to you in much trembling, but his much trembling coming into much power, because in verse 4 and 5, he said, my speech and preaching was not unto you with enticing words of man's wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power. Paul said, when I came to you, I was shaken, I was scared to death, but when I stepped forth and told with cold feet and said, God, you told me to do it, and I'm trusting you. And when he opened his mouth, the power of God showed up. He didn't look like a man scared, he didn't look like a man trembling, but he was. When he approached the call of God, and God did miracles through him.
Yes, praise God.
Woe unto us when we're so confident in ourselves, we don't even need God no more. Hallelujah. Praise God. Verse 21, and he slew an Egyptian, a goodly man. That means a strong man. And the Egyptian had a spear in his hand, but he went down to him with a staff. Don't you see this now? Got a strong, big man, Egyptian man. He's got a spear, a knife. Most simple, but now he's got a staff. I mean, he just got a stick. And he plucked, listen, he plucked the spear out of the Egyptian's hand and slew him with his own spear. Somebody say biblical karate. Son, he took a stick to a sword fight and beat that joker. Amen. Lord, and got up one side and down the other and took his sword from him and killed him. Somebody say one man. One go. That's enough for victory. Don't you dare look around at your situation and think I'm all about myself. How can I do this? Hello? How can I accomplish this? Friend, God don't need your help. All he needs is your faith. Trust him. Stand in what he says to do. And he'll take care of the rest. Somebody say, rest in the Lord. And the Lord will take care of the rest. Amen. Stand on your feet tonight.